Let me tell you a sad story about psychosis spiraling downward out of control. This is a video, a public video of one of my best friends, former best friends, we're not friends anymore. They threw me away, we'll get into that later. Basically, for about 5 years, we were extremely close best friends. The whole time he would use psychedelics, the only time my vice was smoking cigarettes. But near the end, when I was having my own mental issues about self-harm and all that negative stuff, he suggested shortly after me getting out of the hospital to try psychedelics. And again, I was in a very vulnerable place. My whole family was out of the country, and I had just gotten out of the psych ward, and he was really my only rock at that point. And so I took him, and I had a horrible, horrible reaction. And luckily, he was a decent person, and didn't just throw me away like his 70-year-old husband wanted to, or his other high, heavy drug-using friends wanted to. Luckily, he put me to bed, and that was that. But later, he wanted to use that against me as if that was going above and beyond taking care of someone you gave stuff to. So with that said, I learned in that moment, psychedelics are not for me. I cannot handle them, nor do I want to handle them. And it was just really sad looking and listening to my former best friend like this. He's currently in Australia, which is good for him. But apparently he's still heavily using, and it's sad that he could go halfway around the world and still need substances to be happy. It's sad that you can go to a whole other country or continent or whatever you want to call it, and be in a whole different hemisphere across the globe and still need substances to be happy. I know I am probably more mentally ill than this person, but thank God that I don't use substances like this. I would hate being the type of person to videotape me in and out of consciousness while using. The last time I saw someone like this was when I was hanging around someone who would snort H. I'm not going to say the actual drug, but it's the common one, the opioid. And it's just really sad that this is where he is. I wish him the best. He shouldn't have thrown me away because I'm pretty sure he'd be a healthier person if he didn't. But with that said, I'm going to add him to my rosary, and I just don't think he's going to live that much longer.